Hi, welcome to the Lockdown Economy, a social non-profit initiative by the think tank AltiContacts to help small businesses and self-employed professionals overcome the challenges of the pandemic and reactivate the economy. My name is Ramin, and today our guest is Shayan of Shayan Atir Photography. And let's begin our conversation. Hi, Shayan, how are you?
Hi, Ramin, I'm well. How are you?
I'm great. How's COVID treating you?
I mean, it's interesting to say the least, but can't complain. I think all in all, I'm grateful that we're here and we're surviving. So I'm grateful.
Yeah, that's good. Shan, can you tell us a bit about your business?
Yes, absolutely. So first of all, I just want to thank you for making me a part of this project. It's always a humbling and gratifying experience to be a part of things like this. And I think now, especially with COVID and just global connectivity coming to platforms like Zoom, I think it's even more important than ever. So first of all, I just wanted to thank you for making me a part of this process.
I just said thank you for coming. Thank you for being a part of this.
No, it's my pleasure. My name is Shayan Atir. I'm the owner and CEO of Shayan Atir Photography, which is basically a studio which operates in two wings, the commercial wing and our editorial wing. In our commercial wing, what we essentially do is we provide photography and videography services for events, from corporate events to smaller events such as intimate gatherings. But primarily our niche and specialization is weddings. And then our editorial wing is essentially responsible for fashion and product shoots and things of that nature. So we essentially just provide photography and videography services.
Okay, that sounds great. And also, it must keep you very busy, right? With the weddings, with the number of amount of weddings in Pakistan. Okay, how did the lockdown affect your business and the pandemic?
So that's definitely an interesting and loaded question. I think in the spirit of trying to stay optimistic, I think it's absolutely undeniable that COVID has been a terrible tragedy all around. And I don't want to sound insensitive by trying to bring any positivity into this, because our hearts do go out to everybody who's lost so much and the people who've lost people in their lives. And obviously it is a global tragedy. I think that much just goes without saying, but I personally have tried that within the domain of our work, we try to stay as positive as possible, because I feel otherwise it's just, even generally, even without COVID in business, it's next to impossible to survive unless you have that sort of can-do positive attitude. So I've tried to see COVID as a blessing in disguise, in the sense that it's been sort of a wake-up call that I feel we needed. Our business has been running now for 9 years, but I feel, oddly enough, the growth that we have seen as a company within the last year, perhaps, or a year and a half, has been greater than the 8 or 7.5 years prior to that. So the growth has been exponential, because the learning curve has been so necessary in order to survive, because so many of our colleagues and other studios that we often collaborate with, unfortunately, a lot of them had to either be shut down because they couldn't keep up with the financial burden of sustaining operations, or they had to let go of a lot of their employees. I can very grateful to say that alhamdulillah, not only are we up and running, but we do not have to let go of a single one of our employees. We have 32 people who are working under us full time, and there's of course then the part time team as well, but we have managed to retain everybody. However, of course, it has been a massive hit that has been very difficult to cope with, in the sense that, as I mentioned, our specialization is weddings. So naturally, with the pandemic, weddings was not exactly something that was happening in its routine system, because of course, larger gatherings weren't allowed. And for more intimate gatherings within homes, where we were previously sending teams of perhaps six artists, we were now perhaps sending just a single photographer to cover a gathering at home with like 20 people. So naturally the margins that we were making and the work that we could get done, that was severely affected. And also because we have 3 offices that we work with, so at our editing station, of course we had to shut that down. The problem for that was that naturally when you have an office set up and everybody's working there together, it's very different. I'm sure we all can relate to this, that instead when you have to work from home and coordinate with your teams, work significantly slows down. So the work that we were doing, the pace of that was severely affected as well. Because especially in our work, we really collaborate with each other, even for individual product, even for individual projects, we get feedback from each other to just help us grow. Because as artists, I think that's something that's just very important to us. And that was something that was severely compromised as well. Finances, of course, are something that, you know, get thrown around quite a bit. We really had to dip into our savings, and grateful to say that we had that planned a little bit. So we did manage. But all in all, COVID was difficult, but for the sake of our particular business, in a sense, it became necessary, because it reminded us that what we had been doing previously for those 8 years before was that we had a model of sustainability, but not growth. Now for business, that's essentially suicide, because we were comfortable in the fact that we had our day-to-day operations going, we were steady, we were fine, but we weren't really going to that next level where perhaps colleagues of ours had attained that scale that we had within 9 years, they had perhaps attained it within 2 years. And the purpose wasn't to compete with anybody or to be envious, but just to be cognizant of the fact that that same progress could have been reached over a span of maybe 1.5 year or 2 year as opposed to 9 years. So this gave us that necessary push that, you know what, we really need to dive into things. We need to see where we're going wrong. We need to see what we can do to make this company reach its full potential. And I feel we've been able to do that now, maybe more than ever.
Okay, so why do you think it was COVID that propelled you to try to attain that growth?
I think because at that point, COVID became a do or die situation.
Mm-hmm.
Because previously, as I said, that it was comfortable. It was just going from day-to-day operations. I think we weren't really realizing the fact that we weren't necessarily growing. We weren't researching. It was just a comfortable pace, right? But for COVID, we realized that if we stayed within that zone of comfort, we weren't going to survive. It wasn't going to be sustainable any longer. It wasn't going to be good enough. So we had to push the boundary. We had to take it to the next level. And in trying to do just that, we realized how important it was to have done that in the first place. And it's very unfortunate that it had to take something like COVID to give us that reality check, but that it was genuinely that sort of unwanted reality check in a sense. For instance, the fact that we did not have separate wings, we didn't really have a diverse portfolio in that sense. And then in a sense, having not all, but almost all eggs in one basket in terms of weddings was something that hit us. It was just a terrible mistake to have made. So during COVID, one of the things, for instance, that we did was that we tried to really understand what exactly the problem was. We tried to identify opportunity. And one such example that I can come up with is that we started the concept of family portraits. Because one thing that was more relevant now than ever was that everybody was essentially staying at home with their families, right? And what that meant was that we had time with our families, whereas previously perhaps we all were very busy with our work. And secondly, it also kind of realized drove this concept back home to all of us, the importance of being with our family. And we were sort of holding on to them. Almost everybody was holding on to their families closer than ever before. So that provided an opportunity to us that, you know, maybe now we can start a package of family portraits where we go to people's houses in a controlled quarantine environment. We take all the safety precautions and we plan portraits with families. So we introduced that, and that was something that was a very successful step, that even when weddings weren't happening, we were doing family portraits, multiple portraits a day. So again, through sort of tragedy, it did open up new doors, and it did force us to find new opportunities where perhaps we wouldn't have noted otherwise.
Wow, that's really great to hear, Shana. And it's great that you were able to cater to the need of the time and to diversify your own business as a result. That's really great.
Absolutely.
So do you know how your customers and your competition were doing at that time?
We do, actually. Another change that we did bring in this time was that previously I wasn't as in tune, and I'm a bit ashamed to admit it, but I wasn't as in tune with what perhaps our competition, who is doing, or where their strengths or weaknesses were lying, or growth points that they had that I could take inspiration from. We were pretty in tune with our clients, but not as much with our competition. And what we did was, we now currently have a person who's essentially in charge of just research. And we're constantly trying to understand and identify the needs of the client and where exactly we can improve. And also, not even to take, I personally, I don't necessarily like the word competition. I try to look at it more in terms of taking inspiration from other artists, because I feel that there are so many artists who are doing absolutely brilliant work. Some are being recognized, some are maybe not getting as much recognition, but everybody's just bringing something to the table that just provides inspiration for me in my work. It's not something that has to be replicated or regurgitated in whatever form they're doing it, but it does give inspiration and it does push the boundaries. And I feel that's so necessary, especially when you're in the field of arts. So now we are definitely researching more. We're understanding things more. And I think that's really enabled us to form better connections with our clients. That's enabled us to create basically better data that is more customized and suited to each client. We used to previously make, for example, storyboards for our clients for each of the events. But now for each client, I privately have meetings with each one of them. We have long discussions where we discuss everything about the event. We make storyboards, we make mood boards, we make color palettes, we review song selection. There's so much ground to cover. And all of that, I think, has added to the final quality of the work that we're doing. And alhamdulillah, I think our clients have taken note of that as well, including clients who've worked with us previously, and they're continuing to work with us now, and they've also noted the difference.
So are you saying that you're attributing some of the difference to inspiration from your competition?
Absolutely. Absolutely. No, 100%. I think when you're younger and when you're starting out, I definitely used to compare a lot, that we are doing this and maybe that person is doing this. I feel that previously in that time, I had a bit more of a negative approach to it, because I was more that, we're doing this, but they're doing this. And it was more comparison in a very negative and toxic way. Now, obviously with age and with maturity, and once you've done this, you've experienced this for long enough, what I realized is that any artist, in fact, that has a vision in terms of what they're trying to create is an artist that I would respect. I personally am extremely indifferent to how many Instagram followers you have or any of that. I think these are such menial concepts to me. I'm far more concerned with the art and the content that they're creating. And I feel there's so many artists who, I'm not even referring to artists wearing weddings. I take so much inspiration from fashion and editorial shoots into my wedding concepts as well. So I think I feel a lot of inspiration from artists, and not just from Pakistan. I feel even the wedding industry in Pakistan is growing so much that I now take a lot of inspiration from artists that are abroad, a lot of artists in Australia, a lot of artists in London, and I talk with them on and off as well. I recently attended, not recently, actually right before COVID hit, I traveled to Vietnam, and over there, I actually attended a wedding over there, and it was something that was so different, but there was just so much to learn from there. So for me, I think all of that adds up to what I want to create as an artist for my clients as well, because I want it to be a special, intimate experience. I don't want it to be the standardized, typical, basic, traditional coverage. I want it to be that something that's one step ahead of that.
I think that's a beautiful approach to your craft.
Thank you so much.
And how's your business going now that the lockdown has eased a bit, and what are you planning for the coming few months?
So the lockdown easing a bit, I don't necessarily think I agree with that, because just yesterday, actually, the government announced that the halls and such things are being closed again.
Oh.
So yes, so there's a downturn actually with the third wave and the UK variant. So there's definitely quite a few issues. I think realistically speaking, from what it seems like, COVID is something that's here for a while, or at least in some capacity, maybe it'll increase or decrease, but it's going to be around from what I would assume.
I'm so sorry, can you repeat the specific of your question again? I was asking, how's your business doing now, and what are your plans for the coming months?
Yeah. First of all, I'm really sorry for skipping your question.
No worries.
But the plan for now is, it's not necessarily that COVID is getting easier, but the plan is that over the last year, I'm grateful that we've done well. I'm grateful that we've survived and we've grown. But I'm more determined even than last year that we need to grow even further. And even the growth doesn't need to be steady. It needs to be exponential. It needs to be bigger and better than last year. And I know the odds are stacked against us and everything, but I want those to be hurdles at best, but not something that we can't get past. One thing that I'm really trying to, for instance, do is that even though we are a Lahore-based company and we operate all over Pakistan, and this has been the case for many years, but we haven't covered events internationally yet. I'm trying to break into the international market as well. I did have that plan for last year, actually, but unfortunately, because of COVID, a few opportunities that we had, we couldn't go because visas and, of course, all of that. But now, again, this year, I'm going to try for that again. Let's see how the situation is and if international travel is even possible. But these are some of the things that I'm really hoping to look into. We're expanding our team more. We're hiring people. We're currently in the process of hiring people. We've hired 2 more people. We're looking to hire 3 more. So I'm trying to not look at COVID as this big sort of monster that we just can't get past. I'm just trying to keep things in the flow and just keep the growth exponential. So we're looking to expand for sure in terms of our team, in terms of the scale of operations that we do, and hopefully also across geographical boundaries of Pakistan. So fingers crossed.
Oh, that's great. I wish you best of luck. Do you have any insights for other businesses who also want to grow during the pandemic and all the lockdown?
I think everybody has sort of their own experience. But what I can say from mine is that I think the first thing that needs to change, sort of widely just across the board, is this very sort of pessimistic attitude that's taken over, that since COVID is here, just XYZ things are just not possible anymore. Yes, COVID is a reality, but instead of being defeated by the reality, I think we need to adjust that this is the new normal and how we can thrive within this domain. I think that's something that's very necessary for businesses. This is that point where it is make or break now. Either you will fall and you will crash and that's it, or you will take this as that fire to just take it to that next level. So I would say that for each business, other than this point, the secondary thing that I would say is that it's now more important than ever to really research, come up with a strategy for growth, try to understand what your brand is, build a brand identity, understand your customers, understand your competition, see what the potential of your company is, see where you can grow. Because right now, maybe too many of us are just thinking within just this small box, which is what I've done for most of this business. I think it's important to really push past that now. And that would be my advice to everybody. Try to find the opportunity. For example, we found Family Portraits, which is something we had never really considered before. But we did a lot of marketing on it. We got a lot of traffic going on this. And it was something that perhaps hadn't even crossed our mind before. So really try to push your boundaries past the basics and really research and understand yourself, your competition, your clients, and just build from there. And I really don't think that within COVID, it's just impossible to do those things. It's hard, but it's not impossible.
That's great advice, Shayan. Thank you. And on to my last question. Could you name 3 things that you still need help with?
3 things that I would still need help with. Number one, I need help with COVID ending. That would be lovely. No, I'm kidding. The first thing that I would say would be that I think, again, as I said, that since we have been working on strategy, but I do want this year to be better than the last. So I would hope for us improving our growth strategy further to take it to that next level and not get comfortable in the fact, again, just not get comfortable like we did previously. We can't look at last year and say, oh, you know, we did well. We survived. Good job. Pat on the back. keep going. No, it needs to again be that next step. So I think our growth strategy needs to improve further, and it needs to be customized and molded more for the requirements and needs of this year as opposed to last year.
Mm-hmm.
That's the first thing. The second thing is that we are, as I said, we are currently hiring. We filled in 2 positions, but we're filling in 3 more. And I feel that maybe perhaps the way we are trying to access the job market is not necessarily as well as it could be, because I feel there's a lot of great talent and great potential out there who would be a great fit for us. And I feel we're maybe not being able to reach out to them yet. So we're trying to reassess our modes of trying to reach people. So that's the second thing. And I feel growth in terms of our workforce and everything is absolutely crucial to the purpose of what we're trying to serve of growing the company as a whole. Because I feel a team is so absolutely crucial to what we're doing, that the growth of the team is just way up there in terms of our priority. And the third thing that I would say, would be that trying to figure out how to take our company international is something that's definitely a bit of a challenge. Even generally under normal circumstances, but especially with COVID, we are in the process of trying to research and understand that, but we haven't, in all honesty, made too much progress with it yet. So I think that is something that we could use help with as well.
Okay. I hope you get the help that you need. Our business continues to grow and be as successful as you want it to be.
Thank you,
Shayan, for sharing our insights with us. It was really, really inspirational. And thank you to everyone who joined us today. Feel free to contact Shayan using links in the description of the video. And please like this video, subscribe to our channel. On our channel, we have many more insights for you from many different countries and business sectors. I invite you to have a look. Stay tuned.